try to get the way I'm having fun with it. Treat the speech just like the weed, the way I'm fucking running it. How the fuck bungee jumping it? Cardi niggas fell off on some bungee jumping shit. But I'm the reason it used to be dusty. Now we're not busting with the hits. Call me nice, you know, man.
Get in there.
Fuck it, take a rest. Yeah.
Auntie, can I come in for some dub?
Young man, how old are you?
Who's turning this up?
Shout out to the message.
No, man, salute. Yeah, I'm saying, raise up your glass. Yeah, I'm carrying all of that. Salute to the bros.
Once upon a time in London. During the summer of 05 or 06, Keisha was a skit. Boy is color coordinated. 5 day pass was a fiver. Jamie Oliver single-handedly bent over school dinners and fucked it in the arse whilst Grime Music found its record distribution on the top deck and the back seat. Local London bus. These were the days of Sony Ericssons and Bluetooth music transfers, and these were just the things you grew up knowing. Now, sitting on the fence of facts and fables amongst the things that you may or may not have just grown up knowing in the summer of 05 or 06 was the merciless massacre of the snake charmer. Emerging as one of the foremost exponents of his vicious and venomous style. Legend has it that the Nomad would travel from place to place and land to land, charming people through the melodies he sang. He had broken the most deep-rooted taboo and found not guilt, nor anxiety, nor fear, but freedom through decapitating the heads of those he charmed. If truth were known, and believe me, in the ends it usually was, when several different versions, but if it were not, one could say the massacre, despite its viciously venomous, barbaric, and sadistic contour, was at heart a simple case of show and tell. Who knows? Till this day, the motives of the snake charmer remain unknown. What was known was his brutality.